गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू सॉल्विंग द पेपर. नेक्स्ट सम, y इक्वल टू एक्स क्यूब बाई 8 माइनस 2 बाई एक्स स्क्वायर. कंप्लीट द टेबल ऑफ वैल्यूज. दिस वैल्यू इज गिवन 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 गिवन. हियर यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट एंड ओवर हियर ऑल्सो यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट. टू गेट दिस वैल्यू, हियर इट इज y. So to get y here, in place of x you put 3. So how much will it become? 3 cube by 8 minus 2 by 3 square. So this, how much do you get? So this one you get around 3.15. And same thing when I want a value here, x should be replaced by 3.5 now. So 3.5 cube by 8 minus 2 by 3.5 square. The answer that you get is 5.2. So here it is 3.15 and here it is 5.2. For 2 marks it is 4. Next one now. The graph y equal to this much between this has already been drawn. On the grid, draw the graph from 0.5 to 3.5. So 0.5 to 3.5 you need to draw. So when x is 0.5, how much is y minus 8? So 0.5 is here, minus 8 is here. Next one. When x is 1, y is minus 1.9. So 1 and minus 1.9 will be here somewhere around. It should not touch 2. Next is 1.5 and minus 0.5. So 1.5 and minus 0.5 will be somewhere around here. Next is 2 and 0.5. Positive 0.5 it is. So it will be somewhere around here. Next number is 2.5 and 1.6. 2.5 and 1.6 will be somewhere around here. Next number is 3.5 and 5.2. 3.5 here, 5.2 somewhere around here. Now join it. Clear? So now next one. Use your graph to solve this one. So this equal to y we already have. This equal to y means y equal to 0 is x axis. So where is x axis and this graph meeting? That is the answer. Okay. Suppose x axis and the graph is meeting here. So this is the answer. So your answer should lie in the range between 1.7 to 1.8. Okay. Now next one. X cube by 8 minus 2 by x square equal to k, where k is an integer. Write down the value of k when this has one answer. So this equal to y. And this is also equal to y. It should have only one answer, means this line and the curve should meet at only one point. They should meet at only one point means if y equal to minus 2, I get the line over here. In how many places is it meeting the curve? 3 places. But according to my condition, it should meet it at only one place. So above this point, wherever I draw, it meets the curve at only one place. So my condition is k value should be greater than or equal to minus 1. At this point, it is minus 1. No, less than minus 1. So from minus 1 onwards, anywhere you draw the line, it will meet the curve at only one point. Next one, 3 answers. So same thing. If k value is less than minus 1, it will meet the curve in 3 places. Anywhere around here you draw. it will meet in three places. So that three places is the answer. Did you understand? Now next. By drawing a suitable tangent, estimate gradient of the curve at minus 3. So gradient formula is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. One of the point you take minus 3 itself. So when x is minus 3, how much was y? Y it's not there. So you calculate. When x is minus 3, how much will you get y for minus 3 whole cube minus 3 whole square? You calculate and place it here. And other value you take on the tangent, anywhere on the tangent, you draw the tangent at minus 3. Now this becomes x1, y1, this becomes x2, y2. Place in this formula. Your answer should be minus. So place in the formula. In this formula, your answer should lie between 2.524. Okay. Next one. I am assigning you the work of drawing the tangent and find out. Now next one. By drawing a suitable line on the grid, find x. Again, this side you have the graph. This side you have the graph y equal to. This side also you take y equal to 6 minus x. It's a straight line, you get a, it's a linear equation, you get a straight line. For that you need the points. So take x and y. So when x is 0, how much you get y to be? 6 minus 0, 6. When x is 1, it is 5. So points are 0, 6 and 1, 5. Draw this line. Wherever this line and the curve are meeting, that is your value of x. And it should lie between 2.823. In between this, you should get the value of x. Okay. Now next one. The equation x cube by 8 minus 2 by x square equal to 6 minus x can be written in this form. Find the values of a, b, c. So first, x cube by 8 minus 2 by x square equal to 6 minus x. What will be the LCM on this side? 8x square. So this with what do I need to multiply? X square. So x cube and x square is x power 5 minus, with this what do I need to multiply? 8. 16 equal to 6 minus x. Next is cross multiply. So x power 5 minus 16 equal to 8x square into 6 minus x. Now 8x square to this and also to this. So it becomes 48x square minus 8x cube. Okay. Now bring all to one side. So x power 5 first. Then x power 3 means plus 8x power 3. Then minus 48x square. And minus 16 is already present on that side. Now compare it with the given one. What is the given one? X power 5 plus ax cube plus bx square plus c equal to 0. Compare it. What is the value of a? Plus 8. Next, what is the value of b? Minus 48. What is the value of c? Minus 16. Okay, students. So now the next sum. There are 100 students in a group A. 100 students in a group A. The teacher records the distance d meters each student runs in 1 minute. The results are shown in the cumulative frequency diagram. Okay. Find the median. Total how many are there? 100. So median is middle at 50. So at 50 draw a line. So this one will be 200, close to 280. So that is your answer. Okay. Clear? Next, the upper quartile. Now, upper quartile means 75% of 100, which is equal to 75. So, draw the line at 75. So, this will be your answer, which is 320. Next one, interquartile means upper quartile minus lower quartile. Upper quartile you got 320 minus, how much is the lower quartile? Lower quartile is nothing but 25% of 100. So which will be 25. So at 25 draw the line. How much do you get? You get around 230. So 320 minus 230 will be 90. So that is your interquartile. Next, the number of students who run more than 350 meters. Meters is on x axis. 350 is here. So draw the line. That means 90 students have below 350 meters. So above are only this part. How many of them are here? 100 minus 90 is 10. So that is the answer. Did you understand, students?